Kast Off Kinks, playing as a kink?
Well, it's kind of completely different, really. We all get on really well. There's none of that friction on stage or anything like that, which added a lot, actually, in as far as the Kinks was concerned. When both of them were on stage, they created a certain amount of energy that you know, was quite formidable when the two of them were really working together. I mean, both their voices blended brilliantly together. Dave's higher voice and Ray's sort of baritone's voice. And the energy on that stage was, you know, was unbelievable. But we've all grown up, we've got a bit older, quite a bit older over the years. And we're a bit more laid back than that, but we still, you know, find a bit of energy to get people up singing and enjoying themselves, you know. So, and it's a really enjoyable gig. We play those great songs, lots of people know them, they'll join in, you know, and then we throw in all sorts of odd ones that perhaps people haven't heard of, unless they're real Kinks fans, that, you know, kind of introducing new music to them, really, that maybe they wouldn't have heard. So that keeps us, our set list varied as well, because obviously we have to play the hits, that's what people expect, but to be able to pick and choose other album songs, you know, that perhaps people wouldn't have heard.
But the songs themselves are so good and so well constructed, you don't get bored playing.
They're kind of the sort of songs that are everlasting. You know, they don't, in some music dates, you know, but Ray's songs seem to just be fitting any time, you know. Really.
I have to ask you a bit about Morpeth and about, this is your third time here.
Yeah.
And you're playing to help your old fan, your biggest fan, probably.
Yeah, well, he's not biggest in stature, but he's certainly in enthusiasm, let's say that.
Yeah.
No, Terry's wonderful. I mean, the first time we came here was for the hospice that, sadly, his brother spent his last days in. And the second time, I believe, was for breast cancer. I think this one is for Tiny Lives.
Yes.
And they're all good causes. And he put so much work in to get people here, doing his job. He just tells everybody about it and it's always been a really good gig to play, and everybody enjoys it, and it raises quite a bit of money for his chosen charities. So long may it last.
Don't ever set me free. I always wanna be by your side. I'm Carol Meredith. I'm head of Tiny Lives. We're a local charity that supports 700 plus families now from across the northeast and Cumbria when they go through that traumatic journey of having a premature and sick baby and are treated in the special care baby unit in the RVI in Newcastle. I'm delighted to be here tonight at this Kast Off Kinks concert, supporting Jessica, who was born 9 years ago prem and underwent that very traumatic journey. We're a local charity, as I said, and we have to raise over $250,000 every year from a standing start. So it's vitally important that people, local communities, local groups, local companies support us and put on events like this and raise funds and do sponsorship and come together, local communities supporting the local communities and those families from across the region.
Do you find that parents and relatives babies who've been benefited from the unit in Newcastle are helpful in doing this sort of thing and supporting you?
Oh, tremendously so, tremendously so. It's amazing how people throw themselves into fundraising for us. They do everything from abseiling off the Tyne Bridge to organising concerts like this and family days. And without them, basically, we wouldn't be able to survive and do what we do and help the RVI be at the cutting edge of neonatal care for those future families who need our support too.
Just give us a little idea of the sort of things that you provide that wouldn't be available otherwise without your work.
What we do is we say we're very family focused, so we provide emotional support. We're looking at counselling for parents when they're on the unit because it is such a traumatic time. We provide financial assistance if you're travelling from across the region. We fund bus travel passes that cover the bus, metro and trains. We provide practical support and emotional support and financial assistance. And every family that goes through the unit gets a keepsake box from us with stickers and a progress journal, etc. So we're really from those small things that mean a lot to families right through to the cutting edge projects and research that will benefit families in the future.